It was almost 11 o'clock in the morning on the 28th of September 1969 when, above a small rural town in southeastern Australia, a fireball was seen flying through the sky. That fireball broke off into three parts and left behind a cloud of smoke. Half a minute after that, a tremor could be heard. This was when something called the Murchison meteorite hit our fair planet. That rock broke off into lots of fragments, with one bit going right through a roof and landing in some hay. The total weight of all the bits that were found was almost 220 pounds. It became one of the most studied meteorites ever, and one of the reasons why was that it contained a lot of organic compounds. The question scientists have been asking since then is, did life on Earth come from outer space? Some theories state that life on Earth started in something referred to as the primordial soup. This soup contained organic molecules, and those include amino acids, which are the building blocks of proteins. There are plenty of theories as to how life got there, but scientists agree that the soup was left in the pan for many millions of years, and eventually complex life forms were created. We've done an entire show on why you exist at all, and suffice it to say, it's a complex matter. Today we're going to concentrate only on meteorites that might have carried life here. A meteorite is a part of a meteor that breaks off and doesn't burn up before it gets to Earth. A comet is a chunk of ice and rock that moves through space, often with a tail behind it. An asteroid is a large piece of rock that usually orbits between Mars and Jupiter, but sometimes gets thrown off course. A meteor is a rock that burns up, and this is why they're sometimes called a shooting star or a falling star. Meteorites are the rocks that actually get here, hence we can look closely at them. Researchers have for many years been looking closely at the one that hit Australia in many pieces. In 2010, the Scientific American wrote about new research which revealed it contained millions of distinct organic compounds, and that it was far more complex than first thought. At the time, scientists were still trying to work out just what the meteorite contained, since it was not straightforward. One researcher said, "It's exciting, but also it scares me at the same time. We have a lot of work to do to even pretend to understand what this stuff is." A few years later, and a planetary scientist at the University of Chicago and a NASA astrophysicist got together to do an experiment. The Smithsonian explained that those scientists created a computer model of the solar nebula. This is the gaseous cloud from which it's theorized our solar system was formed. That was way back in 46 billion and a bit BC. The debris in the model consisted of 5,000 icy grains moving about for millions of years. That's simulation, of course, not actually millions of years. Within these grains were water, carbon dioxide, ammonia, and other molecules. Their computer model revealed that when irradiated by the sun in this experiment, something profound happened. The Smithsonian writes, "High-energy ultraviolet radiation broke molecular bonds, creating highly reactive atoms that were prone to recombine and form more stable and sometimes more complex compounds. The process could have created organic compounds, and with that, proteins, RNA, and DNA." The theory those scientists came to was that possibly those organic compounds made their way into the rocks in the early universe, some of which later got together to form planets, such as the one you're sitting on now. They might have also been part of other rocks, such as comets or meteorites, that at some point made a splash in Earth's primordial soup. Scientists explain that because of Jupiter's gravity, some of those things called planetesimals couldn't join and form a proper planet. Planetesimals could be said to be very small bodies of rock and dust, which measure over 1 kilometer in diameter. But Jupiter's gravity forced them to smash together, and this formed a massive asteroid belt. From this asteroid belt, smaller rocks might have traveled to Earth. What's interesting about this is that if life on Earth did come from those rocks, then they might have carried life to other planets outside of our solar system if the same conditions were present. Now, fast forward to 2019, and listen to what some NASA scientists and some Japanese academics had to say about what they found in two meteorites. They discovered something called ribose, which is a sugar found in RNA and DNA. Why is this important? Well, we'll let one of the Japanese researchers explain. He said, "The research provides the first direct evidence of ribose in space and the delivery of the sugar to Earth. The extraterrestrial sugar might have contributed to the formation of RNA on this prebiotic Earth, which possibly led to the origin of life." They say possibly. Nothing is certain just yet. On NASA's own website, it states that the discovery of ribose in a meteorite is just the latest of important compounds found in those things, adding to the list of what we already talked about. When big rocks broke and then smaller ones hit the Earth, they could have been carrying the essential ingredients that would, in the end, make us. NASA explained that the messenger molecule RNA copies genetic instructions from the thing we know as DNA. The point is to deliver messages to cells that read the message and build proteins. That's how things are made in the life business. The researchers explained that the new discovery gives a lot more credence to the theory of life not bubbling up through vents underwater to reach the primordial swamp, but something that hit the swamp from space. NASA wrote on its website, "Other important important building blocks of life have been found in meteorites previously, including amino acids, compounds of proteins, and nucleobases, compounds of DNA and RNA. But sugars have been a missing piece among the major building blocks of life. So maybe this was the missing part of the puzzle. Just some sugar was needed to make the conditions sweet enough for life to arise. More research needs to be done and other rocks need to be studied. NASA was also quick to say that the sugars in the meteorites could have come from down here. They might have been contaminated by the life already here. The agency, however, thinks that this is unlikely after analyzing the rocks. It's still up for debate, but the next video you need to watch definitely isn't. Go watch our incredible video, Astronomers Are Speechless After Spotting This Inside Black Hole, right now for more insane space mysteries.